बेसिक लिस्ट मेथड्स, लेट मी वॉक यू थ्रू व्हाट इज बेसिक मेथड्स व्हिच वी कैन डू ऑन लिस्ट ऑब्जेक्ट्स. सो फर्स्ट लेट्स डिफाइन अ पर्टिकुलर लिस्ट. लेट्स से दिस लिस्ट वन हैज एलिमेंट 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. सो इन पाइथन लिस्ट आर वेरी वेरी यूजफुल ऑब्जेक्ट्स. दे डोंट हैव फिक्स्ड साइज. वी कैन add an element from a list, we can remove an element from a list, we can update a particular element at a particular index. So those sort of things we can do. So that's why lists are very useful objects in Python. So we'll see now how we can do those. There is an important append method. So what it does, so it permanently adds an item to the end of a list. Let's say if I want to add a new element to a list, so I can simply call in the append method. So the rule for it is this: you specify the list variable. So list one is our variable, which is a list object containing these elements. Then we do dot, and then we write the method name. So that is append. And then within a parenthesis, we provide which element we want to add. So here we've added append me is a string, which we want to add, get it added to the list object, list one. So see, so the original list, which we created had one at the end. Now we have added, using the append method, append me. You can do a lot more things using this. So let's say I want to add a float number 1.43, so it will get added. So if I print list one now, for consistency I'll just add a cell below 1.43, which is of a different data type as these, but it's a part of a list. You should now be already familiar with the fact that a list can have different data types. So now we can add a list to a list as well. So simply in the append argument, so you can provide the list object which you want to add. So I'll do list1.append, and then it will add the list object list entirely to our original list. So for example, let's say if I wanted to find out what was my last element of this list, which is indeed a list. You can add a lot many objects. You cannot simply add string object or a float or integer. You can also add a list object to a list. So because a list of list will be a list. And then we can call in the extend method. What will extend method do? As opposed to append method, where we provided the 1, 2, 3 elements in a list, we pass a list element. So it added the list entirely. So it did not pick out the inner elements and then append it to the original list, but extend method will help us do that. So in extend method, we provide the same list and we apply it on the list one object, and it will give me 1, 2, 3. So as you can see here, this 1, 2, 3 has been obtained by the append method, but this 1, 2, 3 has been obtained by extend method. So based on your requirement, based on what operations you need to do, so you can use these methods on a list object, and then you'll get your result. So we talked about how we can add element to a list. Now let's talk about how we can delete element from a list. We can simply use a pop method on the list object, drop a particular element. So in pop, what we need to do, we need to provide the index. So here we don't need to provide the element name, but we need to provide the index. You should be really familiar. So there are two important things. One is the index, which specifies the location, because we're dealing with character, with objects which are in sequence. And then there is the element, which is the element sitting at that particular location. So in pop, we'll have to specify the index and not the element value. So for example, let's say specify 1.43, which is this value. So this will not work. It tells me integer argument expected. So I can specify 0, which is my 0 index. That is my first element. So it gives me the item which I have dropped. So one was the first element and it has dropped it. Calling these methods change the list totally. So my first element should start with 2 now, because I've already removed. Pop method helps us to remove an element by specifying the index of the element which we want to remove. So for example, let's say I want to remove the last element. So I can simply do this one. My last element is 3. This object gives me the object which will be removed, unlike the list.append method. So this gives me the entire list by adding that particular object which we want to add to the list. But in the pop method, this will return me the item which I want to remove. Here you can only specify the index, nor you cannot specify the range of the index, but you can only specify a particular index. So here, let's say list one is now, as you can see, the last element has been removed. So there's another method as well for removing the element. here we can specify the element itself and not the index. So remove method helps us to deal with this issue. So let's say I specify this particular string, append me here. So it will remove that and I'll see my list one again. So yeah, append me is not an element of this list now. These methods act on the list and does operations such that it changes the list itself. So as you can see here, during these operations, the size of a list has increased, it has decreased, we have added new element, we have removed a few elements. We can change the data type of the elements as well. So those things will be covering. So yeah, so list1.pop, so what it will do. So if you do not specify the index, what it will do, it will pop out the last element in the list, which we have now, list one. So the last element is 2. So this should ideally give me 2. So if I do not specify any index here within the parenthesis. So if I do popped item, yeah, it's 2. Now we can call in the reverse method to reverse the list. So the last element will be the first element, and the first element will be the last element, and based on that, it will be done. So I call in the reverse method, and my new list will be updated, and my string, the elements will be in the opposite order. So now we have another method. So the reverse method reverses the list. The sort methods can sort the list in the order. So I'll print the new list here. So now my list is in alphabetical order. Sort method helps us to sort the elements of the list and then return the new list. Now let's move to nesting of lists. A very useful feature of Python data structures is that they support nesting. So we can have data structures within data structures. So as I talked about earlier, we can have a list which is itself a list of lists. I here have 3 lists, as you can see here. Now I can make a list of lists by simply defining those elements within the square brackets. So this will be my list of lists. So let's say if I want to extract the first element. So the first element is list one, which is 1, 2, 3. So it should give me the list, which is 1, 2, 3. And similarly, the first element will be BAD, which is my second list I've specified here. Now let's say if I want to extract this element in the second element, so how should I do? So I do 1, which is the second element, which is my list 2, and then so it should give me B. So yeah, so in that way we can create objects which are list of lists itself.